The first thing that we want to do is we want to alter our name.html file to give it a form where people can enter in their username and also add interactivity so that when we hit submit, we're going to pass that username to the lobby.html file on the URL. Okay, so let's first open up the current name.html file. So what I want to do is in our browser, in the terminal window, I'm going to go ahead and run our node server, get it up and running, and then I'm going to open a new browser so that we can see what we've got there. And looking at localhost 8080 and name.html, I can see what our server and our browser together are going to render. Okay, we see we have a very basic name page present. So I'm going to open a new terminal, and I'm going to, in here, go to my directory, and in a text browser, I'm going to edit the name.html file, which is located in our public directory, where we'll serve it from our web browser. All right, so I'll do edit in a text browser. Okay, here's my name.html file, which I'm about to edit. And let me just put it in place here so that we have space to see it. Okay, and the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to go up here and I'm just going to remove this comment that says required meta tags because whatever. And then I'm going to add a title tag so that it passes our HTML lint check, which will be how that we end this editing section. And I'm going to say, just call it enter your username for Reversi, and then end it with the title close tag. Okay, that's good. The next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to come down here and remove the boilerplate. This is the name page with similar text. Say enter your username. Oops. And changing it like that, if I come over here and re-render on my page, we can see that everything's going okay. All right, the next thing that I'm going to want to do is I'm going to want to add a form there. And so for the form, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the Bootstrap form templates in order to make sure that I do a form correctly and do it in the, you know, the style that Bootstrap prefers. And so for that, I'm going to, within the same container, I'm going to add a new row that's going to contain the form information. And so I'll give that a new row. And I'm going to start using single quotes because later on we're going to need to use double quotes within single quotes. So I'm going to use a class row, and then within the class row, I'm going to put a column just like before. And I'm going to have two closing div tags that are going to close out those nested tags. Clean up a little bit here. Okay. Now, within my column, I'm going to have a form, and that's going to be its own tag. And the form is going to have a class, and that is going to be a single quote. Again, oops, make sure I don't mess up my single quotes here. That class is going to be single quote form inline, and that's a Bootstrap style that we're going to use. Just like the other tags, my form will have a closing tag as well, and let's clean those guys up. Now within my form, I'm going to have a class, which is going to be a Bootstrap class, which is going to be a equal to single quote form group. And this is a way that Bootstrap uses to keep different form elements together. And within my form group, I'm going to have a label, and I'm going to have an input. Now I'm going to need to add some additional elements to that, of course, and that's going to entail having some attributes and some content as well. And then the last thing I'm going to want outside of the last thing I'm going to want outside that div is going to be a button. So let's start with the button. We'll have a button, and we will have that be a type, which is this is HTML. And the type is going to be a submit button, and that's going to be what we're going to click on when all our content is ready to go. And using Bootstrap types, I'm going to make it a BTN, which is the button class. I'll use button default, which will give it a styling. and then I'll give it a button primary, which will give it a kind of coloring as well. The button itself will have the text done on it, and then we'll have a close button tag, and I'll bring it all back up on the same line. Now with this, we should be able to rerun our re-render our text over here, and we can see we do in fact have some kind of input field and a text button. So let's go back and adjust our labels then. All right, so the first thing that we want to do is on our label, we want to say this label is actually just going to be present for screen readers because we're going to have placeholder text in that text field instead. So the screen reader text we want to have read to people if they are using a screen reader is enter a username. And that's what we'll have read to them when they're trying to figure out what to enter in this field. Meanwhile, the placeholder text in the label will make equal to enter your username. And let's just make that consistent up here. So it's enter your username. All right, now if we re-render, we can see that we get a label out here. That's the one we're gonna make disappear in a second. And then some placeholder text which says enter your username. All right, now the label, we're going to assign it, we're gonna match it to a certain input by giving it a for attribute and then giving it the value of which element it's for. Actually, let's go back for a second. Let's give our input an ID, which we're gonna leverage again in for our label. And we'll say our ID for our form element is going to be called username. And so we can access this with CSS styling elements or anything else that we want. But we're also going to access it here in our label. We're going to say this is the label that is for the element username. And we will give it some bootstrap styling, including column, form, label, and we'll say screen reader only, SR-ONLY, and then end that with a single quote. All right, and the last attribute we need to give attribute three additional attributes for it to render correctly. We'll give it a bootstrap class of form control. We'll give it a type, which says what kind of data we're inputting, and we'll say the type of data we want is text. And the last thing we'll do is what we want the default value to be, and we want the default value to be empty because we don't want to assume someone's username. Save all that and then come over to our form and reload it, and we can see we get a pretty good styling here. I kind of wish this was lined up correctly so that it wasn't offset here. And I'm not sure what, oh, there we go. That's just an issue of the responsive web page pushing it down. Not sure exactly what I did in order to make that align, but. Okay, so now we have a web page, and the web page allows us to enter our username in. And what we need to do now is we need to add the interactivity so that when the user clicks on that and adds their username to the field and then hits submit, we actually pass it to the lobby HTML page with the correct username in the URL. So to do that, we're going to come up to our form element and we are going to give it an action. What the action means is what web page should we send our, we're not going to do action. We're going to do this a different way. We're going to put a little bit of JavaScript code into this form. And we're going to use the attribute onSubmit, all lowercase letters, single quote, and we're going to call a function when someone hits the submit form. And we'll call it submit with a capital F form, open parenthesis, close parenthesis, and then another single quote. And that should be good enough to call a function, which we haven't defined yet, whenever the user clicks on the submit button. All right, they click on the submit button, and now we actually have to give them the code. We have to give the web page the code that it's going to run. We'll put some inline code up here at the top, just like we have the style tag inline. We'll also put some inline JavaScript. So I'll give it an open and close script tag, and then we're going to define the function that we just referenced. We'll say the function submit capital F form, open parenthesis, close parenthesis, and then curly braces. We'll put our curly brace at the end so we have a matching pair. And then within the body of this function, we're going to create a variable called username. And that username, we're going to grab the element that is in the form using some jQuery syntax, which we really haven't had a chance to talk about yet. We'll look at it in our next week. All right, so we'll do a dollar sign, open parenthesis, single quote, hashtag username to find the element whose ID is username. close parenthesis dot val open paren close paren semicolon. And that's going to grab the value that's in the form and store it in the variable username. And then what we're going to do is we're going to reload a new page. And we're going to say window.location.href equals. So we're going to change the URL that our window is currently open on. And we're going to change it to lobby.html question mark username equals single quote plus username. So that will append the variable that we just grabbed from our form to the end of the URL, and then it will reload this web page. So if I save this and I bring my main web page over to the foreground here, and now we have name.html open, I've saved my HTML, and if I refresh it and I type in djp3 and I hit done, something didn't go quite right, so let me look and see what happened there. What I expected it to do was to go to lobby, and it didn't do that. So let me see if I can check out if anything happened in my console, if something didn't load right or I had some kind of a bug. Okay, nothing's in my console, so I don't see anything that was just a basic error. So let me just go back to my code and see if I can figure out what happened. All right, as I look at my code, I know I entered a title and the title is okay, and style, and I have some JavaScript, and I have submit form. Make sure I spelled submit form the same in both places. And I think that I have my ID username correct. And I have a placeholder text correct here. Let me make sure this is a single quote on both sides. That looks good. And my button has open and close tags, and my label has open and close tags, and my input, actually, let me change my input so that it, well, that should be fine, I guess. Okay. All right. Well, I don't see anything that's wrong here. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up a URL validator. I'm going to go to the HTML validator and see if I've done anything wrong. So I'll go to the W3C online validator check. I will select all of my code and I will copy it, and I will go to the W3C markup validation service. I'll do direct input. I'll paste all my code there and check and see what it says. And it tells me that a stray end tag input. Okay. So this is one place where perfect XML and HTML vary. When you have input tags, you don't put a close input tag. You're just going to close it right there by putting the syntactic sugar, making the shortcut tag close. I'll select all that again. I will put it into my checker and check it now. Oops. Check. And my result says no errors or warnings to show. And so then if I have no errors or warnings and I come back to enter my username and I reload it, what I want to see is after I enter my username in and I hit done, it should go to lobby. Okay. And now I've got another problem. It says uncaught error. Bootstrap's JavaScript requires jQuery. jQuery must be included before Bootstrap's JavaScript. All right, so I know that has to do with scripting. If I come over here and I look at the code down here. Okay, one thing that I was missing is down here in my submit form. Right after I hit submit form, I need to put a semicolon and then return false after that. And by doing that, now when I have my, when I reload my web browser and I type in my username, there we go, and I hit done, that's the behavior that I wanted. I wanted to go to lobby.html. passing the parameter username equal to djp3, although I don't have lobby.html built yet, that was the goal, is to try and get it to that point. Okay, that was good. So now what I want to do is I want to push it out to Heroku and make sure that this functionality works on Heroku. All right, so to do that, I'm going to bring up my source tree browser and get. When I look at what uncommitted changes I have, basically I just have name.html changed, which is what I expected. So I'm going to commit that. Updated name dot HTML. Send that off to GitHub. And then Heroku should load it up in a second. And I open my application. I go to Let's Play. I enter my name. And great, we're at lobby.html. All right, so that was the first check that we did. We went to name.html. We created a form. We added interactivity. We did a check with our HTML validator. We tested it and committed it. First chunk done. Thanks.